When you think of football and college presidents, you usually think of Gordon Gee, right? Former president of the Ohio State.
First guy that comes to mind for me, really. In all seriousness, he's the first guy that comes to mind.
Okay. So did you hear what he's... Yeah. Well, what's his most famous line regarding with Ohio State football?
Well, calling a tie with Michigan a win, which...
Yeah, not only a win, the greatest win in Ohio State history. 1992, yeah. That tie is one of our greatest wins ever. Wow. All right. So he's, he's now the president of West Virginia University. He takes care of Bobby Huggins over there. Listen to this stuff. Have you heard this yet?
No.
We need to get over the panic. We need to be calm about this thing. It's here. We have to deal with it. If one of our athletes gets the coronavirus, we can't just shut the whole thing down. We have to learn to control that part of what we're doing. Someone is going to come down with coronavirus and let's be clear about it. But the question is, how do we handle it? Do we have isolation rooms? Do we put them in a quarantine? Then the final thing in terms of college football, is it how do we make sure our own team and the visiting team both are given the same opportunity to protect themselves with from the virus, but also to be able to play the game in a safe environment? That's kind of strong for a sitting president, isn't it?
Yeah. I understand the concern about this, especially in college. I mean, I think you and I have talked about this. I'll pause here for all the snarky jokes about how these players are all paid on the side by their schools. But in all seriousness, you're going to ask these guys to go out and play a sport and risk catching this virus and for not much money, right? And it's not like the pros can make that determination for themselves. Hey, I can collect $3 million in salary and I'm willing to do that.
Well, it goes a step further because what you're asking, let's say at Ohio State, 100 players. You're asking 100 players to be out there, but you won't ask 100, scientists, fans. Well, the fans, but for sure the students who are there. You're not doing anything to protect them, and yet you're saying, all right, 100 football players, go get them, dot the I at halftime.
Yeah, that's why I think there's so, and even in baseball, there are just so many obstacles to get past here. You know, even one more thing on the baseball thing, Les. You know, while they've exchanged this proposal, they still haven't really reached out to healthcare experts in those cities to find out, you know, what they think needs to be done to make this all safe. And I know they say they're waiting for a final proposal to do that, but there's a lot to clear up here. It's really hard for me to believe that this is a possibility of a start in July 4th. I'm starting to think that they just won't be ready to do that.
You're talking baseball now.
Yeah, baseball. Yeah.
All right, let's talk about the other. How about you see some resolution? You're indoors in basketball. Do you see any reason to finish this season? Number one, with all the teams involved, including the Cavaliers, or just saying, okay, the top eight and you top eight in the standings, you're in the playoffs right now. You see either of those things happening?
I just think it would be if you're going to say that it's safe enough for players who are in the playoffs or would qualify for the playoffs right now to come back and play, and then extend the playoffs for whatever reason. I think it's unfair to the players on teams like the Cavaliers that were playing well at the end of the season for them in their development year. And to say to them that they can't come back is, I just think that's unfair. I think you either have to open it up to everybody and let them play for two or three weeks to try to jockey for playoff position or not come back at all. So I just don't think it's fair to let teams come back, only teams that would figure into a playoff series right now.
How about the NFL and college football? Do you see the NFL? Now, the NFL today, at least the Browns made their announcement of what their first two exhibition games will be on the road, last two at home. They'll probably promote that it's Tom Brady in Tampa Bay, but let's be real, he's not going to be playing in game four of the exhibition season. So, A, do you think that season goes off as planned? As we're talking about that date, and what about college? Do you see it also going at that start date, or do you see them actually moving it to spring?
I think there's a better chance that college gets moved this spring than the NFL doesn't happen. I think the NFL, it just feels like that momentum is there. People, as we saw last weekend in certain bars around town, when the restrictions were lifted just a little bit, you know, the horse got out of the barn and was galloping away. And I think it would be hard right now to go back unless there's a real huge spike in coronavirus and in serious infections and hospitalizations. I just think it's a hard thing to go back now and say there's not going to be an NFL season. It feels to me like all the momentum is building toward that. I still don't understand how they're going to be able to pull it off. If we're worried about baseball players handling the same ball, how would you even try to stop in a football game guys from contaminating each other if somebody is positive with the virus? And I know you can give them tests, but I know people who've been tested positive for coronavirus who were test negative to start out. I know people who've taken, you know, you feel a fever coming on and you take Tylenol and it suppresses your fever. So if you get examined by somebody taking your temperature, that's not really proof that you're not asymptomatic and carrying the virus. So I'm not smart enough to figure out how this is all going to happen. Maybe Gordon Gee is, and maybe he's right. No, seriously, maybe he's right that there are going to be infections, and it's just a matter of
what do you do about
how you deal with it and how safe you can make those players and those families feel about this.
Are you ready for NFL flag football?
Yeah, how about that? Yeah, and you'd have to launder the flags between each possession. So I don't know.
It's a college. You go to the dorm, you get a whole bunch of quarters, and you throw them in, do they still have those?
I think they do. I mean, what do you think? Do you think there's going to be an NFL season, and do you think there's an equal chance that college football season will happen?
I think the NFL will play, but I don't think on the date they're talking about, I think they're going to probably not kick it off till mid-October. I think that college football is going to, I see it going to spring rather than fall, but I'd like to be wrong on that one.
Yeah.
216-575-0403. Go ahead.
No, I just say it's, you know, I find myself being, you know, critical of certain things that are, even from a healthcare standpoint, some of the announcements are made out of Columbus and they seem vague. They, you know, one day it's wear a mask, one day it's you don't really have to, we won't make it mandatory. And it gets a little frustrating. But I also understand that people are going through this for the first time and they're trying to juggle 100 things, and including an economy that's tanking. So it's not easy to come up with a hard and fast solution for how to deal with something that we've never had to deal with before.